had been cooped up in the dormitories all that summer and decided we needed to escape that. And as you know, the real estate market in Long Island, summer rentals are very expensive, but winter rentals are quite cheap. So Satoshi and I went around looking for a house, since the market was quite open, we kept upping the ante in terms of what we expected in our house. A fireplace, a grand piano, and a view of the sound. And we found up on the hill in the village in Shore, and we loved it. By the winter of 1960, Satoshi's childhood friend, Yoko Yamada, came to be a graduate student at the Teachers College at Columbia. Her dad had been a major educator in Japan previously, so that was not a surprising direction for her to take. But both Satoshi's family and Yoko's family, I think, hoped that their childhood acquaintance would blossom into something more, as indeed it did. The summer of 1960, Satoshi and Yoko were married, and I was a best man at that wedding. Yoko continued to study at Columbia, commuting back and forth, and Satoshi and I took on the house in Shoreham again for the second winter. By then, also the summer of 1960, the AGS had come online, and the first experiments at the AGS were done. They were, of course, the simplest things you could imagine. Total cross sections. We had 20-foot long liquid hydrogen target and separated beams using Cherenkov covers of pi's, k's, and protons, both plus and minus. And we did the reference to the total cross section that we measured. Phil Love had joined us, as well as Jim Niebuhr, and later in that summer, Ken Foley joined us as well. Some of you may know Charlie Sinclair, who was then a graduate student at Cornell. He's now, I think, kind of the world's expert on polarized electron sources. We published the first paper on those total cross-sections. And as they looked like, the particle and antiparticle cross-sections were approaching one another, and it looked like they were flat, and Sam Lindenbaum invented the term asymptopia, the promised land that we had reached, maybe. As many of you know, although the particle and antiparticle cross-sections did come together, further out in energy, they began doing some kind of interesting things. So asymptopia was not quite as boring as Sam had thought it might be.